Good morning. It is just before 7 a.m. and we are headed off to the annual passholder previews at Magic Kingdom. We have no idea what to expect or even if this is like too early or not early enough, but we are excited to be back and see how it is. So let's go. Hello from Magic Kingdom parking lot. So in the footage that you would have just seen, we drove through the Magic Kingdom parking plaza. No problem, went right through. And then we realized the Magic Kingdom parking wasn't actually open. So we had to go back and wait in the line. And they let us in around 8 a.m. So we are in the first like 30 cars at Magic Kingdom today for the annual passholder previews. So we are on our way in. Look, we're walking to the ticket and transportation center. Yay! Definitely one of my least favorite things in general, but today, without social distancing in place, there are people kind of just everywhere, and I'm not a fan. Do you see back? Yeah, I think I'm gonna skip it for now.
All volume set up. Eat yourself Swahili. Yours, just for the asking, at the office.
Tortuga Tavern area. You see all the tables behind? We really just wanted to drink some water and this is the safest way to do it. You can see the table behind me is marked as for your health and safety, this table is not available. That's how they enforce the distance in these like dining table areas. So anyway, it's been really good so far. We've been on a couple of rides. We've taken some photo pass pictures. The cast members are enforcing masks and distancing. And so far it's been really fantastic. We're trying to gather as much information as possible, but also just try to enjoy it as much as possible. We have a long trip and annual passholder previews aren't exactly like a typical day because everyone here kind of knows what they're doing and it's probably less crowded than it will be when it opens. I don't know, we'll see. We are getting ready to go on Pirates of the Caribbean and see how the queue looks and how they load the ride and all that kind of stuff. So let's go.
Remain seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the bowl.
Cosmic Grace for lunch, and you have to mobile order and wait outside. You can see the people out there waiting. Once your order is ready, then they will let you in if it's time. And then the cast members lead you over to your bay where you pick up your orders over there. And then you can sit down and they have a lot of the tables labeled so that everyone stays apart. The toppings bar is just packaged condiments. So you just grab your condiments here. They are enforcing masks. We ran to get some napkins without a mask on and they said, go back and get your mask on. So that was good. But you can see how the tables are marked like this so nobody sits close together. So it's been really good. It's nice to be able to sit in the air conditioning and to eat. So far, so good. And there's that pink castle.
Food. his grave.
He'll never reach that grave.
Why me? Why me? Oh dear. Can you untie Kangaroo?
So a lot of people have asked questions about how rider switch works, especially because FastPass is gone, and we've confirmed at multiple rides now that what you do is you actually do go to FastPass section or a separate section to get your return time, and then when you come back to ride, you enter that same space. It's for Disability Access Service and Rider Switch. We're in a relaxation zone at Tomorrowland Terrace. I think a lot of quick service seating areas probably are relaxation zones, but this one is officially marked that. So we don't have to have anything to eat or drink, I guess, here, but it's just really a quick service dining area. But I want to talk about a couple things. One is that you can still get PhotoPass pictures taken, and it's just that you have to wear your mask. So the photographer will scan your Magic Band or your park ticket and like normal, but you kind of need to stay as far away as possible. And then you can pose and keep your mask on, and then that's it. So in case you were wondering. The other thing is that there are just random like pop-up character and entertainment things that happen, which is so lovely. It kind of feels Disneyland-ish, because I feel like the characters are so prevalent there and it's not necessarily so scheduled like Disney World normally is. So today we saw the stepsisters on the backside of Cinderella Castle. We saw that there was a Tink float going down Main Street, and then there was the Goofy cavalcade that came through, and they were really, really cute. But there's no schedule to it or anything. You just have to kind of catch it. If it's a schedule, then people will line up, which they don't want you to do. It just kind of is random, so you can look for it. But anyway, it's been really fun. And we're just kind of cooling off and taking a little break here. Okay, we are at the ice cream parlor on Main Street, but you can see right there it says, sorry, we are closed. So what we did was instead we went to the plaza right here, and they got us right in, and we ordered ice cream from the menu there at our own little table instead of having to walk in here. Hello from the front of Magic Kingdom. I wanted to do one more update because we asked some questions and I wanted to make sure to answer them before we actually leave the park. One of them is about gator masks. A lot of people have been wondering if they can wear gator masks, and we saw people being turned away this morning for having gators, but we also saw people wearing them in the park. So it is confusing. However, they have said officially gators are not allowed. The only people that we saw wearing them were ones that had ear loops and that were really snug, but officially they don't like gators because they usually aren't snug. So I have a gator as one of my many options, and I'm not gonna wear it because they have said it's not allowed. Lots of people have been asking about PhotoPass pictures and masks. I think I've said that a couple times today, but I just wanna reiterate, it's not allowed. So this is how the pictures are gonna look for now. Eating snacks and drinks while walking, that is something that they have said is allowed, but we haven't seen it today, right?
No.
It's really been people like us sitting down at tables that we found, or a bench or something, and just having our drink and having our snack. But officially they say it's allowed. I just think it's an easy policy to abuse, because people will have a bottle and they'll just sip it and say, I don't need a mask, I'm sipping my water all day, or eating my popcorn all day. And I don't think that policy makes sense, but we actually never even saw people really doing it. Speaking of popcorn, people have asked about the popcorn buckets and how they're doing the refills. They are still doing them, but they give you a cup of popcorn to put into your refillable bucket, correct?
Correct.
People have also asked about the cleaning and how often that's happening. A lot of people have said, do they clean it after all the passengers? And they don't do that. That's just not practical. But what they do is clean every 2 to 4 hours, depending on how high contact the area is. So a high contact area would be cleaned every 2 hours, a lower contact area every 4. So it is a routine cleaning schedule, but it's just not after every group or every passenger. Pressed pennies are still available, or pressed quarters, just like normal. Relaxation zones, there are 3 in Magic Kingdom. We found it difficult to find them. There aren't maps available and it's not really listed, I don't think, in my Disney experience, but maybe either we just haven't found it or they haven't added it, I'm not sure, but every park will have that. But I would suggest that you can use relaxation zones if you want an area where you don't have to, you know, you don't have to eat or drink, you can just relax if you want to. There's cast members that are there to kind of monitor and make sure everyone's spaced out. But you can also find quick service dining places that have tables kind of scattered. And I think that can work as a relaxation zone. But ideally you would have something to eat or drink if you're doing that, which is what we did. Anything else on the list today? Did I hit everything? I think that's it, right? Yeah. I think that's it. So anyway, we had a really fantastic day. We were told the capacity was only like 7,000. I don't know what the capacity of the park actually is, but it is likely to be double when the parks are officially open. So we won't have this experience maybe ever again. But if they double it, it's still likely to be way less than normal. So we had wait times of 5 to 20 minutes today. So if they double it and, you know, it could be 10 to 40 minutes. It still wouldn't be bad, but we don't know. So we have lots of like regular park days coming up, and we'll see how it goes. So that is it. That hopefully that answers several questions for Magic Kingdom, but we've got more days. We'll come back and hopefully answer some more. We met friends for dinner at Wilderness Lodge. Isn't it beautiful out here? This is the area down by the lake near Geyser Point. It's so pretty. We're gonna be moving here to stay for a week, but it was nice to be here tonight. It finally cooled down. But anyway, we are going to leave here and go back to Bonnet Creek tonight, but I think that is going to finish out this fantastic, amazing, still magical, but safe day, that our first day in the park. Tomorrow we have a non-park day, but we're going to try to do some fun stuff and bring that to you. So that is it for now. Thanks for watching.